Hello, in this episode of Makerbox Mondays, I'm going to have a look at a filament from Plas3D called Polycarbonate Blue. So let's have a look after the intro. So I was quite excited about getting polycarbonate filament to test out. It's not a very common material I get to test. But it's a difficult material to use, but I'm going to read out the label here. And here they say polycarbonate blue print setting should be 250 to 300 C, and I was using 280 degrees on the hot end. Bed temperature 80 to 100, and speed not listed, and cooling off. And here they say enclosure is advised. And then it say polycarbonate filament is strong thermoplastic material used in 3D printing. It is a good electrical insulator while having a heat resistant properties. Clear PC has high temperature resistance and high optical clarity. It has a high glossy finish, suggested to print on glass bed in good ventilated area. And I was printing on my Prusa printer with a Magico PC adhesive, so that was working pretty good. I had one print going off the bed just was finishing, and I added a little bit more Magico, and then the rest of the prints stuck quite well. I'm gonna show you my prints. So my first print was this little test piece, because they said I shouldn't use any cooling. I decided to print this out to test how it would handle the how the material would set. Well, you can see it's a little bit rough here. It indicates that I need to slow the speeds down a little bit, so the material can settle before the next layer. So that was an indicator of maybe not printing very fast for this material, because it's printing very hot and there's no part cooling fan. But then I printed sear lace a lot, and here I had quite amount of cracking. You can see here all the cracking issues on the edges. And while the print finished without any flaws besides the cracking, and we started to notice the cracking as the print went on, and it didn't fall off. But as you can see, it's very brittle, and layer adhesion is not very good. And I don't know, maybe I should have more heat in the enclosure to prevent this, but this was the issue I had. And then printed my maker coin, and that had the cracking issues as well. And here I had some infill as well, but it got loose off the bed, so I got this blob. But it was just moving with the nozzle at the top. But the details are quite good, but just the cracking issues. And I think I just didn't have the right environment for this material. Then printed a benchy, and that came out pretty nice. Besides, the chimney here melted a little bit, so I needed to slow this down. But for this print, I didn't have any cracking, so maybe on this one I had a little bit more infill. So maybe you need to print with good infill to don't get this cracking issue. You can see here there's no infill, so that's just something that you have to take in account if you're gonna try this filament. And then I did a bridging test, and that came out pretty nice. The overhangs performed really good, and no serious drooping issues, as you can see. Pretty nice. So if the infill addition will prevent the cracking, and you take into account there's no cooling, you could probably get extremely strong prints with this filament. It's quite tough material. This will be it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.